Yeah.
Ah, you need a microphone. Sorry, sir. Here we go. Okay.
I'm busy.
When did you learn to speak German?
In Schwaben.
Schwaben?
Yeah.
How long have you been there?
I have da hier ein Jahr studiert.
Yeah.
Schon lange her.
Lange her?
Lange her. Alt geboren.
Wann war das?
War das schon lange her?
Schon lange her. How many years?
Ja, lang.
Ja, lang.
Wie lang?
Wie lange her?
Lang. Sehr lang. Aber lang.
Lang.
Ja, aber lang.
Lang. What's wrong? Set in the 70s, in the 60s, in the 50s, in the 40s?
Oh, no.
Just kidding. Also, so, ich soll eine Frage anrufen?
Ja.
Ja, haben Sie Fragen oder nicht? Oder nur da Sie so, wo ich sage,
so.
No one has a question.
Die Fragen?
Well, I'll tell you a little bit about it. I'll just talk.
Okay.
I'll tell you a little bit about, we'll start off with Sledgehammer. I began as an actor in a comedy club in Chicago. And then I moved to New York and I began to study acting. And then I wanted to be in the theater and I wanted to be in the movies. And I got this script for television and I thought, oh, I don't want to do television. No. And I read the script of Sledgehammer and I thought, it's pretty funny. And then I read it again and I thought, no, it's no good. And then I read it again and I thought, it's pretty funny. So I talked to my wife and I talked to my agent and I said, why not? Let's do it. So I came to Los Angeles and we did the pilot for the series and it was picked up. And so then I moved with my family to Los Angeles to be on the new Sledgehammer. And the thing I liked about Sledgehammer was that it was a parody, you know, it was satirical. And I don't like cop shows very much. I don't tell anybody, don't tell them, but I don't like, that's just for me, I don't like cop shows very much. So this was a chance to make fun of cop shows. And I didn't like Clint Eastwood very much. I know, but I don't like Clint Eastwood movies, like this Dirty Harry. I don't like it. I think, no, not it. So this is a chance to make fun of Dirty Harry and the police officers. So, and it was a lot of fun because the writing was always very good and very clever. And we really got a chance to make fun of America's love of violence. You know, like this on the car, this Die Hard violence. And so I remember one of the first shows we did, there was supposed to be a big fight. And you always have someone, a fight director, to stage the fights. So he came in and he said, well, you know, you can gouge out his eyes and you can hit him and kick him in the balls and all this kind of stuff. And I said, well, no, let's find out how to make fun of this. So we it was actually in the one called The Witless. I don't know if you remember that particular one of Sledgehammer. But instead of having a big fight with people rolling around, we got it all mixed up and I got my ass was in the camera and we tried to make the fights as funny as we could. As funny as we could. And it was really, I had a lot of time doing it because as I said, the writing was always very funny. And we had wonderful directors. One of us in the you know, Nolan Bixby was a very good director. And every day there was something funny to do. So we got to the set in the morning and started to laugh. And then we finished laughing and went home and came the next day and laughed again. As it turns out, Sledgehammer was on television on a Thursday night in the United States. And the two shows that were very famous, very popular, there were three stations at the time, only ABC, NBC, and CBS. And Sledgehammer was on the bottom. It was the bottom of, there were CBS was in Dallas, and that's when and then there were only like five people watching that channel on ABC. So it was not popular at all. And then came the show was over, and the year was over, and they were trying to decide whether to put Sledgehammer on again, and of course we were at the bottom. So they said, no Sledgehammer. But there was on ABC another show that was very popular, was The Cosby Show. Do you have also hear The Cosby Show? Well, that was on a Friday night, and so the people who were the producers of Sledgehammer had a big campaign, and they said, the only person strong enough to fight Cosby is Sledgehammer. So they had a big hard word cut out of me, the gun, and I will fight Cosby. So ABC had no shows, they had nothing to do, they had no one to go on. So they thought, why not do Nothing to Lose? So they put our show on for a second year. And I think that the producers thought that the show would never go on, which is why at the end of the first season, they had the Adam Bomb go up. They said that they thought there would never be a show again. So then they had to find a reason to have the show on again, and they said that everything in the second year happened before the first year. So that's the So then after 2 years, we were canceled. And then gradually, as the years went by, I would be walking in New York or Los Angeles, and like someone from Uruguay would be parking my car, and he would say, oh, Sledgehammer. And people from all over the world, and I found out that Sledgehammer was more popular in Germany. United States. I don't even think it's on the air in the United States. But in Germany, yeah. So ich bin ein Berliner. I know that's good. Makes no sense. So that's the story of Sledgehammer for us. I think I can tell you, I don't know how many of you are there, if that's why you're here, because of Sledgehammer, but I can tell you my favorite show was called Hammeroy. And I don't know what did you do it to Hamza Poish? Hemoloy?
Yeah.
So it's the same thing. Hamaloy. And that was my favorite one. That's not true. I thought the pilot was very funny. And Witless was very funny. But after that, I think this Hamaloy, where a robot got his arm cut off.
The Elvis episode is cool. The Elvis episode.
What?
The Elvis episode.
Elvis, that was very good, very good. I had a wonderful time doing that. I had to learn how to do Elvis, so the week before the show, I got all the tapes of Elvis in Las Vegas, and I was frantically watching the friends and figuring out how to do Elvis Presley. Yeah, that was a good one, very good. So, and I was very surprised when the DVD came out, and was very popular, and now I'm very surprised that it's back in Germany, and it's all a big surprise. So, thank you very much for coming. It's good to be back in Germany. I can tell you my association with Germany, I'll tell you a little bit about that. My name is Asha, which is of course a German name. I think it was not my name. I think half of my family came from